Today on Warrior Update, Wabanzi has a new athletic director, we give freshmen advice, and we recap homecoming week. It's Friday, September 27th. I'm Sarah Giffen, and you're watching Warrior Update. The athletic department is under new management. Warrior Update gives you an in-depth look at Wabanzi Valley's newest athletic director.
Wabanzi Valley Athletics underwent some changes this summer, the largest of them being the hiring of new athletic director, Chris Nebs. Mr. Nebs has been a part of athletics for most of his life.
My father was actually an athletic director at Wheat North High School for many years, so I was kind of around it growing up. Kind of interesting that I ended up doing this. Started off in the business world. Ended up getting education, and I felt like this was just a good combination of kind of the business side and athletics.
Mr. Nebs is excited to be at Wabanzi and feels there's a lot to be positive about.
Well, I think there's tremendous potential. I think there's a lot of kids that are involved here. I feel like kids really get excited to be a part of the Wabanzi athletic program, and the goal is to make it just a well-rounded, not just individual sports that are excelling. We want to make Wabanzi well-rounded throughout, you know, fall, winter, and spring seasons.
The amount of time committed to the job is a challenge to any athletic director.
You know, like the first week, there's some weeks where you put in 70 to 80 hours. There's some weeks that are not as difficult, you know, in terms of hours away. So I got to find a way to kind of balance that with my family, which is the most important thing. The students, I mean, I think we got a great fan base here at Wabanzi. I just, you know, I want to be known as a classy school. I want to cheer the right way and support our athletes the right way, and I think we do. I want the student population to know that I'm here for them. You know, if they got any questions, concerns, regards to Wabanzi and the athletic program, come in here. I like having conversations. You know, that's the main thing. Is it's an open door here. Whether you're an athlete or not, you know, I'd like to be able to help and assist in any way possible.
For Warrior Update, I'm Quentin Zofi.
From cars to kings and queens, this week has been filled with excitement. Warrior Update recaps homecoming.
Homecoming king and queen were announced Wednesday night. Seniors Emily Palmieri and Sean Pierce. Coronation was held for the first time at Warrior Fest as attendants from all four classes were introduced.
Congratulations, Emily, Sean. You've just won homecoming king and queen. First of all, with you, how does it feel?
It's a little overwhelming. I was not expecting it, but it's pretty awesome. Thank you to everyone who voted. It was a great experience.
Sean?
It's awesome. Thank you for everyone that voted. It means a lot. Thank you so much.
Hey, what are you all's plans now for the weekend? Homecoming king and queen? Any?
Just hanging out with my group. It's my sister's first homecoming, so being with her and spending time with Trent, it'll be our 1 year anniversary, so I'm kind of excited for that.
Just hanging out with Nicole, going to homecoming, having a good time.
Very nice. Well, congratulations again, and congratulations to be a part of Wabanzi history.
For Warrior Update, I'm Rachel Menarek.
Skills USA hosted a car show at Warrior Fest. It showcased two divisions for car enthusiasts, one for community members and one for students. Prizes were awarded in the categories of sound system, junk car, warrior spirit, American muscle, import power, and classic. Warrior Fest attendees were also given the opportunity to take their aggression out on a car. For a couple of dollars, people had the chance to pound a car with a sledgehammer for 1 minute.
For Warrior Update, I'm Simran Patel.
Powder Puff football took center stage and closed out the evening at Warrior Fest. Brianne Charter scored the winning touchdown as the seniors came from behind to defeat the juniors 14-13.
All of us as a team just really connected really well. We're all friends out there, so it's a really fun experience.
Yeah, how were our practices? You had a good coaching staff. How did everything go?
Practices were so fun. Again, we're all just really good friends, and coaches are great, and it really made it a good time.
All right, how did it feel scoring the game-winning touchdown?
It was really crazy. I didn't expect to be where I was, and it just happened, and it felt great. The overall experience was really just amazing time. You see the varsity players out here every Friday night, and it was awesome to have my chance at being out here, and it was just a great experience with all my friends out here, too.
Wabanzi Powder Puff plays Niqua on Monday, October 7th. For Warrior Update, I'm Liz McPherson.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
What is homecoming?
Pretty.
What do you think you do at homecoming?
You dance.
You what? Act crazy.
You crazy dance?
Crazy. Can you show me how to crazy dance? Oh. Do you like dancing with boys?
Yeah.
What's better on a girl? A long dress or a short dress?
Short.
Why?
Because then people can like see the legs.
Who do you want to go to homecoming with?
Beyonce.
Yeah!
Do you like dancing with girls?
No. I do not like dancing. No.
Why?
Because it's so baby. I'm silly.
George nodded and everyone cheered. Well, that silly monkey. Oh, I didn't see you there. But since you're already here, I'd like to take this time to give you a few tips for your freshman year. Throughout my 4 years at Waubonsie Valley High School, I've learned a lot. As technology is ever changing in this school, make sure to know how to use it properly. After seeing my first pitiful attempt at the water fountain, this is how you drink it correctly. I've learned a lot of lessons the hard way, one of them being respect your teachers.
Can anyone tell me the answer to this?
Your mom.
Though the hallways of Waubonsie Valley may be treacherous and scary for some of you freshmen, follow one simple tip to keep you safe. Stay to the right.
Sorry, dude, stay on the right.
I see some of you naive freshmen rocking the two straps on your backpack, when we all know one will suffice.
Hey guys.
Look at that kid two strapping.
Well, kiddos, I hope you can take some of that advice. Have a great freshman year, and remember, go Warriors.
No one gets out that belly line.
That's all for Warrior Update. I'm Sarah Giffen. Thank you for watching.